Today, I bring you something I'm surprised that nobody else has ever done. The wooden Super Nintendo. At the end of the video, I'll talk about making it. But for now, let's prove to you it works. To prove that this is functioning and I'm controlling it and all that. So yeah, did you know if you beat everything in Star Road, all the sprites and stuff change and Mario goes in a weird fall mode. Enough of that. That's what I'm talking about! Playing Donkey Kong on a wooden Super Nintendo. Doesn't get any better than that. On a side note, I am starting to have a little bit of a problem with room to stick all this stuff. I'm gonna have to build another shelf or something. Now, I know some of you might ask, why would you rip apart that beautiful Super Nintendo and its original architecture? I didn't. I got the Super Nintendo with just the motherboard and the controller parts, and I was operating it on a table, and I had no case for it. So, I'm like, yes, I'm going to build one out of wood, and it's going to be awesome. And let me tell you though, it was hard. It took about a week of getting up at noon. I'd go head out to the summer kitchen, start working on it, and I wouldn't stop till about 5 in the morning. Well, I'd take a couple breaks here and there, but still, I was working more than 8 hours a day every day, like total time. It was rough, and totally worth it. One thing that made this project insanely difficult was the fact that I did not own a Nintendo case or a Super Nintendo in any form other than that motherboard. I did obtain one, but only near the end of the project. So I had to just basically go on Google Images, look at a picture of a Super Nintendo, and hope that I could make the right measurements based off of that and the motherboard size. Along with not having most of the parts of Super Nintendo, I also did not have the power cable for the Super Nintendo. My fix to that was desoldering the 12-volt line in from a portable DVD player and putting that in the Super Nintendo, and I beefed up the heatsink on the regulator. Not like I had the original anyways, but I put one from a Pentium 1 processor, Cooler Master heatsink, and fan on there, which means I now have a hardwired switch on the back of it to cut everything off, including the fan. And with the regulator's new beefed up cooling system, I pretty much can throw any power adapter between 20 and 9 volts on it with no negative consequences. I also had odd little ways of creating parts of the Super Nintendo out of wood, just like the original. Like the hinge on the cartridge door is made of sewing needles, and the spring came out of an old VHS tape. The switches are just carefully carved out of wood, and just standard switches you can get at Radio Shack. The controller ports, very carefully carved out of wood, and I mean very precise work. And the ejector, really thick sewing needles and springs from a floppy drive that are actually strapped onto the controller ports. That is all, and I hope this is awesome as I think it is.